Hi guys, today we are going to discuss our new topic, that is the trigonometry. Actually, the trigonometry is a topic which is very important from class 10th point of view, from board exam point of view actually. But it is not only important for only board exams, but it is also important till then we are studying the mathematics. The time which we spend on studying the mathematics, till then the trigonometry will come to us. So we will discuss about what is trigonometry actually is. So the word trigonometry is arrived from the word Greek, that is a trigo means triangles and measure, metry means measure. Means actually the trigonometry is a branch of science branch of maths in which we will discuss or we will calculate the triangle, we will calculate the angles and the sides of the triangle by using the trigonometry, right? So what is the trigonometry? Till then we will discussing about it. Now to study about the trigonometry, we will have to discuss some important points or some important terms which will be used throughout this chapter. These important terms are, that is the trigonometric ratios. So first of all, discuss that what where we can apply the trigonometry. The trigonometry, actually we have discussed about the trigonometry can be applied only in triangles, but the most important things which we have to kept in mind, that trigonometry can only be applied to the triangles which is a right angle triangle. Means to apply the trigonometry in any triangle, the one angle should be of at least 90 degrees. If the right angle triangle does not exist, then we cannot apply the trigonometry, right? So let us consider a triangle ABC, in which let's say AB is the perpendicular, BC is the base, and AC is the hypotenuse, right? So now we will define some important terms, that is the trigonometric ratios, which we will use throughout this chapter. These terms are suppose sine theta. So what is theta actually? Let's say the angle C is known as theta. So sine theta can be defined as the perpendicular upon hypotenuse, right? Now the next trigonometric ratio is cos theta. What is cos theta? Cos theta is defined as the base over hypotenuse, right? Now the next thing, that is the tan theta. Tan theta is defined as the perpendicular over base. Tan theta is defined as the perpendicular over base. Actually, these three terms are known as the basic trigonometric ratios. Three more trigonometric ratios also exist, but these are derived from these three trigonometric ratios. Let us discuss what are the next three trigonometric ratios. So let's erase this triangle and see what are the other trigonometric ratios. The next trigonometric ratio which we will define is cosec theta. What is this? Cosec theta. Cosec theta is defined as the reciprocal of sine theta. What is cosec theta? Is defined as the reciprocal of sine theta. So cosec theta is it, and we know that sine theta is equal to perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Then the value of 1 upon sin theta is hypotenuse upon perpendicular. That is very simple, right? So now the next trigonometric ratio is sec theta. What is this sec theta? Sec theta is simple. As cosec theta is reciprocal of sin theta, similarly the sec theta is reciprocal of cos theta. So sec theta is equal to 1 by cos theta. So what is cos theta? Cos theta was actually base upon hypotenuse. So simple, 1 upon cos theta is equal to hypotenuse upon base. So the next ratio is cotangent, that is the cot theta. Cot theta is reciprocal of tan theta. Tan theta, what is tan theta? Tan theta we have already discussed about, perpendicular upon base. So cot theta is defined as the perpendicular upon, 1 upon tan theta, and tan theta is defined as perpendicular upon base. So cot theta will be defined as the base upon perpendicular. These are the six trigonometric ratios which we will discuss throughout this chapter. And actually we can say that these six trigonometric ratios are the most important thing which we will discuss in trigonometric ratio, trigonometric chapter. If we don't know about these trigonometric ratios, then we can't say anything about the we can't study the trigonometry actually, right? So these six trigonometry, I hope you will be very clear about them. So one more thing which
which I got to know when interacting with the children, that they actually get confused about what is actually the perpendicular and what is actually the base. So first of all, we will discuss that what is the difference between perpendicular and base. Actually, the children got confused that this side, they generally think that the side which is standing, that is known as the perpendicular, and the side which is lying down is known as the base, right? But that is not so. The thing which will define the perpendicular and the base is the angle which we are considering, right? If we are considering the angle as, suppose we are considering angle C, then in that case the perpendicular will be the BC, sorry, the perpendicular will be the AB and the base will be the BC, right? But if we are considering the angle A, then in that case, let's take another triangle P, Q and R. Now if we are taking the angle P as theta, then PQ will be the base and QR will be the perpendicular. So how we will get to know that which side is perpendicular and which side is base? So it's a simple logic that the side which is along with the angle, that is known as the base, and the side opposite to the angle, or we can say the side opposite to the theta, is known as the perpendicular. So I hope it is very much clear about you to the which side we will take as the perpendicular and which side we will take as the base, right? So let's discuss some questions in which we will discuss this topic, that what is perpendicular and what is the base, right? I am giving you an example, just that if you have to measure the height of your house, then this trigonometry can help you a lot. How? Let's say we will come out from our house and move right 4 to 5 meters, and we will just see the top of our house. If in that case, we can measure the angle by using the protractor. We have a method known as kilometer, which we will discuss as we move forward towards this chapter, and then we will know that how can we measure the angle by using the protractor, even anything, right? So if you are going to if you are going out of your house to 3 to 4 meters, and from that point if you are watching your top of the house, then you see that there will be the you know the distance from your house, right? And you also know that what is the angle by using the protractor, as I told you about the kilometer, which we will discuss in this chapter later on, right? So we can say that by using this angle and by using the distance which we move from our house 3 to 4 meters, by using these two things only, we can measure the height of our house, right? So there are some more applications of trigonometry are also there. Suppose we are designing a base, we are designing a road, then in that case also we use the trigonometry for calculating the elevation. As you seen that the roads of the or the highway roads are banked from the side, as you seen that, na? So that is actually use of the trigonometry. There is very wide branch which we will use, or we in which we use the trigonometry to calculate different things, right? Actually, in science background, trigonometry plays a vital role in doing measurements which we will require in designing different instruments, different roads, different constructions, etc., right? So that is about the trigonometry applications. As we move towards this chapter later on, we will discuss that there are some many more applications also, which we will discuss in this chapter, or we will come to know, right? So till then we have known about what is the trigonometry, actually what are the applications of the trigonometry, and what are the trigonometric ratios. Trigonometric ratios are nothing but the ratio of the sides, that's why they are known as the trigonometric ratio, right? So let's take a question. Suppose we are given with a triangle A, B, C, in which let's say AB is equal to 3 cm, BC is equal to 4 cm, and you have to calculate the angle C. What you have to calculate? You have to calculate the angle C, right? So as we will already discuss about the Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem, what is the Pythagoras theorem? The square of the perpendicular, that is the AB, plus the square of the base, that is the BC, is equal to the square of the hypotenuse, that is known as the Pythagoras theorem. So by using this we can calculate the angles. Let's say first of all we will calculate the side AC, after that we will calculate the angle A and angle C. Let us discuss. Suppose AB is equal to 3, so 3 square, BC is equal to 4, then it is 4 square. We have to calculate AC square, right? So 3 square is equal to 9 plus 16, and that is equal to AC square. So AC square is equal to how much? 25, and AC is equal to under root 25, that is comes out to be 5. So we have calculated the side AC as 5 meter. Now suppose anyone asked to calculate about what is the angle C and what is the angle A. So let us discuss. So till then we have calculated about the AB, BC and AC, right? Now we know the all sides of the triangle by using the Pythagoras theorem. Now let's say we have to calculate the angle C. So we can define as sine C is equal to, as we discussed earlier, sine C is equal to perpendicular upon base. So perpendicular here is AB, and the sine C is equal to perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So here perpendicular is equal to AB and hypotenuse is equal to AC, where AB is equal to 3 cm and AC is equal to 5 cm. So we have calculated that sine C is equal to 3/5. So C, angle C will be defined as the sine inverse 3/5. Now anyone can ask that we have calculated the angle C, but what type of value is this? We have different type of techniques in which we can calculate the value of inverse. As we move in the trigonometry further on, we will know that how can we calculate the angles also, right? So we have calculated the angle C. Similarly, we can calculate the angle A also. How can you calculate the angle A? Sine A is equal to, now in that case we can define BC as the perpendicular and AC as the hypotenuse. So sine A is equal to perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So perpendicular is BC and hypotenuse is AC. So what is BC? BC is, as clear from the figure, BC is equal to 4 cm and AC is equal to how much? 5 cm. So the sine A is equal to 4/5, right? So A is defined as the sine inverse 1/5. Now if someone asks that you have to calculate the other trigonometric ratios, if we have we are given with the two sides of the triangle, then what will you do? Then in that case, very simple, we will calculate the third side of the triangle also, as we do in this case. After that we can calculate the all the trigonometric ratios. Suppose we have to calculate sine A. So sine A is equal to perpendicular upon hypotenuse, perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So perpendicular is BC, hypotenuse is AC, so this is equal to 4/5. Now we have to calculate cos A. How will you calculate cos A? Cos A is equal to base upon hypotenuse. Base is equal to how much? Base is equal to AB and hypotenuse is equal to AC. So AB is equal to 3/5. Now we have to calculate tan A. Tan A is equal to perpendicular over base. So perpendicular over base. Here perpendicular is equal to 4 cm and base is equal to 3 cm. So perpendicular over base. Now if you have to calculate the cos A, sec A and cot A also, then as we know that cos A is equal to sin A, just the opposite of the sin A or the reverse of the sin A, then we can write that cos A is equal to 5/4 and sec A is equal to 5/3 and cot A is equal to 3/4, right? Cot A is equal to 3/4. These are the six trigonometric ratios which we have calculated only then if we are given with the two sides of the triangle, right? So as we move in this chapter further on, we will discuss the rest of the things which are also important or the interesting also. So till then, goodbye.